Just got a quick announcement for you guys before we get into today's video. I'm coming at you from my beautiful backyard here. As you guys can see, this is my brassica bed full of amazing plants. Anyways, today we're not talking about the plants real quick. What I want to talk to you guys about are the cool Growing Your Greens t-shirts. You know, for those of you guys that are long-term brewers, you know that I had a one-time Growing Your Green t-shirt sale, and that money was destined to helping me have money to buy a farm, which I'll give an update in a minute. But since that time, the t-shirts are not available, and people ask, John, where can I get one of your t-shirts? And I say, sorry, that was like a one-time shot. So I want to let you guys know, for a limited time, we're bringing the t-shirts back again. So if you guys want to get one of these cool t-shirts, it's the dark navy with the green lettering, or actually my favorite color, the green t-shirt with the white lettering, you guys could now do that. So I'll post a link down below this video in the description so you guys can get your t-shirt. Also, I'll have a little link at the end of this video, at the end screen credits, so that you guys can link out and actually get a t-shirt. Now, I want to let you guys know that your purchase of a t-shirt goes directly to help me continue to produce, make, get videos edited and published for you guys. It takes a lot of my time, effort, and expense to make all that happen, and I've never asked for one penny from you guys, and I will never ask any money for you guys. But if you guys want to get a t-shirt where you get something, and then you want to help me also, please buy a t-shirt. They're really cool t-shirts. I got these specifically because I got them designed to fit, you know, me. And that's important, because a lot of t-shirts I go, if you go to some store, they're gonna fit kind of baggy, and I really don't like baggy t-shirts. So these ones are actually really nice fitting shirts. And I guess the last thing I wanna say is an update. So I've been searching for a property to buy. I use some of the t-shirt money plus some other money I have to put a down payment on a property. I'm into Puerto Rico, Hawaii, South Florida, a few other places. And basically, I decided on Puerto Rico, and then unfortunately, then the hurricane happened. So that kind of delayed that plan there, and now I'm probably gonna have to wait about 3 years before anything goes on further having to do with buying land in Puerto Rico. So meanwhile, I continue to look for property, and at this point, I'm probably looking at Hawaii. I need to make another trip over there, maybe possibly Maui. Anyways, on with today's show. Once again, if you want a t-shirt, check the link down below in the description. Get yours while they're up and available, because it may disappear at any time. Alright, this is John Cola with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for him. Still here in South Florida today. I'm here in West Palm Beach area. Actually, right off the 95, I don't know if you guys see that in the video, but on this side, you know, there's the busy freeway, so it's kind of loud until we get inside for a minute. But where I'm at today, I'm here at Got Sprouts Organic Live Food. So what the Got Sprouts does is they grow wheatgrass, sprouts, some microgreens, and also provide seeds so you guys can grow your own sprouts and microgreens. And if you guys are long-term viewers, you'll remember about, I don't know, 3 or 4 years ago, I made a video at Got Sprouts, and actually they're at a different location, and since that time they've massively expanded. Oh my god, their warehouse is so huge. This is probably the biggest sprouting operation that I've seen anywhere. And they don't just grow sprouts the normal way, right? The sprouts they sell are a lot different than the ones you might find at your local grocery store, you know, that can be like they use chlorine to grow them. They don't use any chlorine to grow their sprouts at present time. And that's because they grow mostly produce, because they're actually growing most of the sprouts in soil. So what I want to teach you guys today is actually how the largest sprouting grower that I've ever visited, how they grow the sprouts, so I could show you guys how easy it is so you guys could do it at home, you know? And if you guys don't want to do it at home, rest assured, if you guys want to buy sprouts, Got Sprouts ships sprouts throughout the country. You know, they've shipped it to California, and they shipped it here in the local area. They deliver here in the local, you know, South Florida area as well. Anyways, let's get off the noisy highway, literally, and head in first to their warehouse. They have a warehouse that's employees only, and then a storefront that's actually over on this side. I think we're gonna go head into the warehouse first to show you guys actually the whole process of growing the sprouts here at Got Sprouts. So now I'm gonna give you guys actually a very rare back of this house tour of Got Sprouts. They have a normal storefront actually in the front of the building, but we're here at the back of the building in the warehouse, and as you guys can see, it's Got Sprouts, but it says restricted area, employees only. So if you come here, don't come to this door, go up to the front, they'll be sure to help you out. But I was given a special access to show you guys how they grow this stuff, you know. I really think it's cool when places have an open door policy and allow me just to come in and actually wander around on my own and show you guys what's growing on, because, you know, they want to be fully transparent. You know, they want you to know that when you buy the sprouts from God Sprouts, they're growing a good quality product without any kind of, you know, nasty chemicals, right? The other thing that's important is, as people at home, you know, you may live in New York City or Maine or Connecticut or Michigan right now, and you're still got snow, well, depending on what time of year you're watching this. But, you know, God Sprouts also wants you to grow your own sprouts if you don't want to buy it from them, and they'll provide you good sources of seeds to do so. So, I mean, the main purpose of me walking through the warehouse and showing you guys how they do it, I'm showing you guys how they do it on a large commercial scale, but easily you guys could do what they do on a commercial scale on a smaller scale for you and your family. Anyways, let's go ahead and head inside the warehouse and show you guys what they got growing up. So walking in the warehouse here, it's actually a fairly busy place. They got people packing and shipping all the orders that are going out. We'll maybe talk about that later, but what we're gonna talk about first is actually this big room. I mean, I think this is a 12,000 square feet of warehouse space. And look at this, this is just racks and racks and racks of the sprouts they're growing here at God Sprouts. And you know, these racks are not rocket scientists, guys. You don't gotta spend a ton of money to make some racks. Look, all you need to do is buy some PVC. This is 1.5 inch PVC. Schedule 40, that's the thick stuff, and they basically just built these racks out of the PVC. All these components to make the racks are actually available at your local Lowe's or Home Depot or other hardware store, right? In addition, as I wander through here, I want to point out the lighting. Look at all the lighting up there. Now, they didn't invest in special high-priced LED lighting or anything like that. They got basically standard industrial lights. These are just fluorescent light fixtures. They're really expensive. You could just buy some similar ones at Home Depot or Lowe's near you. So, you know, you don't have to buy these special ones, although some places might recommend them. You know, they just use standard full spectrum light bulbs that you could buy at your local Home Depot or Lowe's. So once again, don't say to yourself, John, I can't grow those sprouts or microgreens because I got to get the special lights. They cost a lot of money. I can't afford it. No, go down and get a light, you know, fixture and the full spectrum lights. And if you can't even do that, I'd recommend actually going to Costco. Costco actually recently just had their LED shop lights on sale for $20. They put out a lot of light. They're not full spectrum, but hey, the plants will still grow even with standard light that's not the right spectrum. They just may not grow as fast. So I do always encourage you guys to get the right full spectrum light bulbs whenever possible. But as you guys can see, we walked through this full warehouse growing all the greens. But before we get into actually how they're growing the greens, I want to talk, or then the sprouts, I want to talk actually over here where they got all their trays and supplies to grow, to let you guys know what you're gonna need to grow the sprouts. So probably the first thing that you're gonna need to grow the sprouts, and actually the most important thing you guys are gonna need to grow the sprouts, are the seeds. You need to have good seeds that are meant for sprouting. I mean, many people just go down to the local health food store and buy seeds meant for eating, and then they do sprouting with them, and of course that will work. That's a really low cost option for you guys to buy different bean sprouts and things to grow. But the challenge is that the seeds meant for human consumption may not have a high germination rate. They may be a little bit older and not have the germination rate that they need to have, because you are growing literally fresh produce out of the seeds. So I'm glad to say that here at Got Sprouts, unlike some other seed sellers or sprout seed sellers, they actually have a full-on business actually using the seeds that actually they sell to you guys to grow your sprouts. They actually use these seeds in their commercial business, and they wouldn't be selling you guys seeds that didn't germinate well, because I mean, they use these seeds every day. They instantly know if there's a bad batch of seeds because they're using these seeds to grow their products that they actually sell. And then on the side, they'll also say, hey, you guys could buy our seeds, which are high quality seeds, because they do it on a commercial scale and they sell only organic seeds. And that's another thing that's very important to me, and hopefully you guys out there too. I don't want you guys buying conventional seeds for you know, sprouting, if you can afford it, right? I know everybody wants to cut corners and save a few bucks here and there, but conventionally grown seeds may have pesticides and other things applied to them, especially if they're not specifically meant for sprouting. Also, they may not be as healthy. So what do I mean by that, right? So take this for example, like this in your mind, like say you and your partner are eating a McDonald's-based diet, which I do not recommend. That's a standard American diet, right? I mean, we all know that we are what we eat. If you eat McDonald's, you're gonna be made out of all the nutrients in McDonald's foods, right? And maybe you'll have a baby that hopefully is healthy, you know, God forbid, but maybe it's not so healthy. It has a runny nose and it's sick. It's, you know, it's not as healthy because the parents didn't have all the nutrients that they need to be healthy. right? I mean, it's proven that, like, babies need essential fatty acids, you know, DHA and stuff. And if you're not getting DHA in the mama's diet, you know, the baby may have some challenges with the brain and all this kind of stuff. And, you know, we accept that. But what Vietnamese people don't realize is that the seeds, you know, the seeds are actually the babies of the plant. So if you're using conventionally grown seed and they fed those conventionally grown plants just NPK fertilizer, which are, they focus on three main minerals, you know, not and maybe up to 16 to 18 minerals, those seeds that are produced may not have all the nutrients they need to be fully expressed. So they might be smaller, they may not have as big of a germ, they're gonna weigh a little bit lighter, and they're not gonna have, more importantly, all the stored nutrition in the seed, which basically is what you're eating when you're eating the sprouts. You're eating the stored nutrition that are activated by enzymes. So in organic, you know, in general, but not always, organic food is more nutritious than conventionally grown food. And I hope that more organic gardeners would take their growing to the next level and start adding things like rock dust, you know, to add even a wider spectrum of trace minerals. And of course, I do encourage you guys, if you guys are going to get into sprouting and microgreens, hey, grow some of these guys for sprouts and microgreens, but take some of the seeds you get and grow them out in your garden under ideal conditions with good soil, rock dust, and sea ocean solution solids and sea minerals to get up to 90 different minerals, and then save your seeds every year and then use those seeds to then grow your next batch of sprouts and microgreens, so you control the entire process and you're actually not having to source external sources of seeds. But I'm glad to say the seeds they have here, some of the highest quality seeds that I've seen. So aside from starting with good seeds, you also need to have a few other things depending on the kind of sprouts you're gonna grow, right? The majority of the sprouts they grow here, they grow in soil. And so if you are growing in soil, you're gonna need two things. You're gonna need the soil, which they have some nice organic soil here, plus the container that's gonna hold the soil. I mean, the container could be, you know, something like even like old cafeteria trays that used to, like, you know, get your McDonald's burgers on. I don't think they have those anymore. Or it could be, you know, these, you know, heavy duty 10 by 20 nursery flat trays that are commonly used. And look at this soil here they're using, man. This is nice, rich, and black, deep Florida soil, composted soil. So, yeah, and then they have just trays and trays of all these guys basically ready to get planted out. Another thing you're going to need to use to grow sprouts is water. You need to have a good, clean source of water, you know, that's microbial free, very important. So they use a good, you know, source of water here that's microbial free. So don't use like just running stream water, river water. Don't do that. That's a big no-no. Use some good, clean water. And I mean, that's pretty much it. I mean, even if you're not growing in the soil, you could just grow sprouts only in water, you know, and that's a different kind of sprout. And actually, at the end of this episode, I'm going to show you guys the easiest sprouts you guys can grow and actually should be growing in your own kitchen. I guess next, I think I want to take you guys on the journey of how they grow some of the sprouts in the soil here at God Sprouts. So the first step of growing sprouts is you need to have the seed and you need to have a few other things like a bucket or some kind of container to soak the seeds in. But before you even get to this stage, there's another stage that's super important, is once you get your seeds, you need to wash and rinse your seeds very well, right? And so depending on different places I visited, right, they could really take the time to properly soak and wash and scrub and agitate the seeds to get any kind of debris that may have come on the seeds with the seeds. You know, so depending on how you want to do that, you know, wash the seeds, rinse them under water with a colander, make sure the water can free flow and drain out for a little bit. I don't know, maybe a couple minutes. Maybe you could soak the water, soak the seeds in a tub of water, swish them around in there for a couple minutes, and then drain that water off, and then put them in your container, such as they're using food grade 5 gallon buckets to soak their seeds. And here they got some pea seeds growing in the back there. I don't know if you guys can see that. They got the wheatgrass seeds, and over here they got the sunflower seeds, and they got these on the top of the sunflower seeds basically just to weight them down, because the sunflower seeds, because they do have the hull, tend to float up and rise up. So you need to soak these seeds for the appropriate amount of time, and depending on what seed you're soaking, that's going to determine the time. If I remember, I'll put a link down below in here for the proper soaking time for each individual seed. And you know, it's not, I mean, if you soak it a little bit longer, it's not a problem. You don't want to soak it too much extra, but you don't want to soak it too short. because the germination process then will not start. So the next step after you got your soaked seeds and they've been soaked for the proper amount of time, then you need to spread out your seeds and actually literally plant them. And that's what they're doing in this stage. As you guys can see, the row goes down and down. I mean, this is the most sprouts I've seen anywhere. And it's kind of actually refreshing to be in this room and see all these little baby green plants like emitting the oxygen. The air is super clean in here as well. You know, they got good air flow. Very important if you're growing these sprouts, even in your home, have a little fan going on these guys. Because without proper air circulation, especially here in South Florida, you could get lots of mold, and that's not a good thing. So basically on here, what they've done is they have a couple different flats here. They have actually three flats here, although there are really only two flats of growing. This top one is actually just a tray to basically put darkness on the little seeds here, because if the darkness is not on the seeds will not basically orientate themselves properly and start to grow down and send their roots down, right? The seeds seek light. That's what they do. I mean, they're programmed to seek light. It's like heat-seeking missiles are trying to get heat, and these seeds here are trying to seek the light, right? But, you know, when they're just starting to grow, we don't want them to get any light, so they basically cover them up. Also very important, you know, in the first step is I showed you guys some of the trays that were already pre-made. You know, they packed in the soil down there, just, you know, not even that deep. Maybe like, I don't know, half inch deep or so in the trays, so you're not really using that much of the tray. And then they evenly spread the seeds in the tray and then basically tamp them down a little bit, right? So that the seeds are like into the soil. And if we lift this tray up, you can see even in this bottom tray, you know, these are also been tamped down and also now in the dark. So we're gonna leave these guys back on there. So they're in the dark too. And basically at this stage, the seeds are starting to germinate, and there may be a day or two when it's during this stage where you're just keeping it like this and you're keeping this properly moistened. That's very important. You know, you don't want to overwater these guys, you don't want to underwater these guys, you need to have them properly moistened. I mean, that's one of the biggest challenges in growing the sprouts or microgreens, that people tend to overwater or underwater. You got to get it just exactly right, right? It's like when you're playing darts, you want to get that bullseye, that's the optimal place to hit on the dartboard, but if you hit on the outer ones, you know, it's going to work because you're going to get some points. And in this case, you know, you want to make sure you get the proper moisture. What is the proper moisture? You know, you don't want to have water dripping out of the tray. You want to just, I would just basically use a sprayer to spray down all the seeds to moisten them properly, and so that there's a little bit of water on the surrounding soil, but it's not sopping wet, right? And likewise, you don't want them too dry either. To me, these guys look a tad bit dry, and if I was running this place, I'd come around with a little sprayer and give them a little hit of water. You know, maybe the watering for today is actually due really soon, because it's, I can tell it's still dry on the floor here. So anyways, let's go ahead and go to the next stage of the wheatgrass or other soil-based sprouts being grown. So now I want to show with you guys the next stage of the wheatgrass being grown. It's kind of cool to show up, you know, and just kind of check out and see where everything's going. But anyways, you guys just saw the other trays I showed you were just basically planted, right? The seeds have just germinated. They were planted in the ground or the soil. And now here's the next stage that I found. If we take off this top, look at these seeds, right? These seeds have been growing. They start to have the roots. The roots are getting kind of longer. The roots are trying to find the soil. They're trying to orientate themselves down. And this is just only a day or two after they've been planted. These guys grow really fast, right? They're like off to the races, and they have only one mission in life, is to grow and set new seeds so the genetics can continue. So yeah, I mean, the sprouting could happen really fast depending on these kinds of sprouts and depending on your temperature and your weather. You know, about 10 days approximately is how long it can take you to grow the sprouts here, whether that's the wheatgrass, the sunflower, or even the pea sprouts. So now I want to share with you guys actually the next stage of growing the wheatgrass or other sprouts. Basically what happens is, the seeds start to germinate, the tails get longer, it sends roots down in the ground, then the next stage is the green shoots or the plant starts to grow up and they try to hit the light. So the next stage is they'll be like, they still have the tops on there as a weight to hold them down to keep them dark. And then right when it starts to get pushed up, so like this tray is just starting to get pushed up, they remove the tray. And as you guys can see, once you remove the tray, now you have the little plants that are all growing. And and they're all pretty much white because they're not getting any light yet. So they're not greening up because they need the light, the fluorescent full spectrum lights from above to hit the growth to actually turn it green. So this is just the baby stage where the roots are fully developed. Let me hold this up for you guys. I don't know if you guys can see in there, but you guys can see like the roots in there. They're really white roots, fully developed. And now look at this, just a few days after they've been planted, you can see down through the bottom, the roots are actually starting to come out the bottom of the tray, right? It's totally amazing. And now the roots are trying to absorb nutrients from the soil. So they use a good organic soil here. But in addition, besides nutrients coming from the soil, the majority of the nutrients are actually just stored in the little seed itself. The nutrients in the seed are being used up and converted to basically fuel the growth of the plants. Lots of enzymes and different reactions are happening in the seeds. And that's one of the reasons why I believe sprouts are so good for us, because they are a living food. Right from the time they're growing, you want to take them and cut them only right before you're going to eat them. Cut them and then eat them, and you're going to have some of the most vibrant or life force food in the entire world. So here's the next stage in the sprout's journey to grow, and this is it. After they come out and they're kind of white, they're going to sit here another couple days, and soon enough, they're going to actually grow taller and they're going to turn green. So look at these. This is like really nice stuff here. These are nice and green grass grown fully indoors, so there's no like external contaminations, because I know a lot of you guys may be concerned about chemtrails and jet fuel and radiation in the outside air. It's fully clean in here. There's no outside stuff getting on this. And definitely another reason why you guys should grow your own food on the indoors inside your house. Look at that. And then check out the roots. The roots are still popping out the bottom, starting to turn brown a little bit. And these guys have just been growing here. And they got to do is just sit them here and just keep the appropriate amount of water. Let's see if we could pull this up, right? Look at this. Now, unlike many places that grow the wheatgrass, this is fully like not only hydroponic. Like some places only grow wheatgrass hydroponically. They're growing in full soil, right? And to me, in my opinion, this makes for a more nutritious product, because the roots, although a lot of nutrition comes from the seed, there's also nutrients in the soil that the roots are interacting with. So you guys can see the really nice tight root mass in here. The roots are fully surrounding all the soil in there to pull the nutrients up to the soil to get the wheatgrass greener and even taste better. Now I want to stop there for a second. Actually, I didn't talk about this earlier, but the kind of the seed you use to grow the wheatgrass is of critical importance, right? Just like if you go to the store and buy apples, right? If you go to the store and buy apples, you could get Granny Smith apples, you get Red Delicious apples, you get Fuji apples. And what many people don't realize is that, on the wheat seeds, there's many different varieties of wheat seeds, although they're just labeled wheat. They're using a hard winter wheat, and even above and beyond that, even if you get a hard winter wheat, you could have one hard winter wheat from one farmer, and it's a little bit different cultivar or variety than another farmer, depending on where in the country it's grown. And the farmers save their seeds, so they have their own kind of hard winter wheat. So they've sourced the best kind of hard winter wheat, for the most vigorous growth and healthiest grass. So this brings me to the last stage of growth, and this is like a conveyor belt line. They just move the plants down, or they just keep rotating the different racks and the areas that are ready to harvest. So these guys actually probably ready to harvest maybe later today if they got some time, or probably tomorrow. But you guys can see these are nice and tall. Look at this. This almost looks like a nice lawn. If you're a kid, it'd be cool to play on this stuff. But this is a lot more valuable than just your lawn grass. This is the fully grown, or almost fully grown, wheatgrass that they'll soon be harvesting and then shipping out to people, or actually just selling the whole flats to local juice bars or even cruise lines, right? And this is nice and tall. And the most important thing about the wheatgrass is that you want to get it before the jointing stage. Very important, because you want it just to be the young grass that the nutrition is mostly coming from the seed and not, getting nutrients from the roots yet, although that's occurring to some lesser extent. So this is all before the jointing stage. Once it starts to joint, the nutrition levels go down. So, they don't harvest past the jointing stage here. The majority of the wheatgrass they sell here, they actually pre-cut, so that you don't have to cut it. You have to deal with the soil, the mess, and all this kind of stuff. Plus, then they also get to reuse the soil and get it composted down, so it actually doesn't enter the waste stream, because I know a lot of people getting the flats just basically throw them away. That being said, if you want the highest quality wheatgrass, I always encourage you guys to buy it by the flat, the living flat, because it's still alive, versus the pre-cut wheatgrass. And of course, if you guys are growing at home, you guys are just going to cut your wheatgrass and then use it instantly. In most cases, people use the wheatgrass by juicing it. And if you do need a good wheatgrass juicer, please be sure to visit my other website, discountjuicers.com. I sell the juicers that allow you to juice wheatgrass, as well as many other kinds of things. And if you really want to focus on juicing wheatgrass only and other sprouts and greens specifically, I would recommend the Solo Star 4 juicer, which is the best multi-purpose juicer for juicing the wheatgrass. If I remember, I'll put a link down below to a video I did. Actually, I think I juiced like 7 flats of wheatgrass straight in this juicer. And, you know, I don't recommend doing that necessarily, but this is to show the durability of this juicer, the Solo Star 4. And I just wanted to walk you guys through some other parts of the warehouse to show you guys the sprouts they're growing here. So, I mean, in this case here, they got the pea sprouts or the pea shoots. You know, they're in all different stages. Once again, these ones are once again about ready to be harvested. Look at that, all the way down there, man, like a nice green carpet. Moving over here, I think they got some more pea sprouts that are a little bit younger, not quite ready to grow. Pea sprouts are something that's really easy to eat and to grow also. They grow relatively fast. Over on this side, they're actually using the smaller, you know, trays that are not quite as tall. And they're growing things like the radish and the broccoli microgreens. So, I mean, the process of growing these guys are pretty much the same. The broccoli, you know, might take a little bit longer to grow than the wheatgrass. And, you know, here's some that's actually about fully grown and ready to be harvested. You know, here's some underneath that, once again, they're just doing that same technique I showed you on the wheatgrass. You know, you can use the same technique with I think these are the radish seeds here. They just basically spread them out onto the tray and they're growing them. Or you could do the same thing even with the sunflower greens. So these sunflower greens are almost to the point they're gonna be harvested, maybe like today or tomorrow. But the sunflower greens are one of my favorite to eat. They're just really nice. You could pick that guy off and look at that. Fresh and organic. So now we're in another area where they're actually growing the sunflower greens right here. And sunflower's gotta be the most economical sprout you guys can grow, especially if you're not gonna want to source organic seeds. The reason why I say this is, you know, you can just cut them and eat them. Really super delicious to eat. You don't have to juice them like you have to juice the wheatgrass. The growing process is identical, although you have to weigh the seeds down when you're soaking them, otherwise they will all float to the top. The challenge is, you know, the seed husk will actually stick to the sprout, so you'll just have to remove them. I mean, these are edible, it's just fiber. I don't like to eat them because they kind of like are too gritty and I'd rather eat more sprouts. These ones are just popping up and, you know, they're starting to green up now. And what I want to say is that, you know, while I don't necessarily recommend buying, you know, black oil sunflower seeds that are meant for bird food to grow your sprouts, I do have friends that do that successfully. That being said, if it was me, I would only source organic seeds that are meant for growing sprouts. The bird seed may have some kind of contamination. In many cases, the bird seed may be preserved with preservatives like BHA or something like that. Also be coated in oil, you know. So if you do get some bird seed like from Walmart or something, that's you know, the black oil sunflower seeds for growing in the sprouts, which you totally could do. And if you can't get anything else, can't afford anything else, I would actually encourage you guys to do that, because growing your own food, such as the sprouts here, the sunflower sprouts, are probably one of the best foods you guys could be putting into your body on a regular and everyday basis. Plus, the other thing is, unlike a garden that you have outside, you could grow a tray of these like continually and have a tray ready every day. You just start one tray today, you know, move that on your conveyor belt or a big shelf like this, or whether you want to get a metal wire rack, start a tray tomorrow. And then basically after about 10 days, you'll have one tray ready every day for you and your family to eat. So you could, you know, increase the amount of the leafy green sprouts and microgreens into your diet and in your family's diet. They are 4 to 40 times more nutritious than the full size vegetables. Plus they have other different enzymes and nutrients in there that you're not going to find in the big vegetables. Plus they're really rich and delicious, have a nice nice delicate flavor, and full of water content, something we also really need in our lives. So in the last steps, I want to show you guys actually just some of the superior techniques they use in packing and shipping, if you guys are buying the fresh cut product from them. And then finally we're going to go into the store and we're going to show you guys actually how you guys can sprout your own bean sprouts, even in the comfort of your own kitchen, and just have them ready in just a few days to eat. So then you too could be considered a gardener. So what I'm looking now is actually some buckwheat greens or buckwheat sprouts that have been grown, and basically they cut off this flat and they've harvested this flat because they had an order for some. And this other side of the tray they didn't yet harvest, so that's kind of like cool. It's like a half and half tray, half harvested, half not. And you know, the buckwheat is another sprout that I really like a lot, and this is what it looks like. And I like the sunflower greens because they're kind of more crunchy, and these are kind of more soft. They're kind of good, nice, delicate flavor. And, you know, if you're saying, John, what sprout should I grow, man? Like, I mean, each one has their own pros and cons, right? I mean, I think to start off, you should grow radish microgreens, or, you know, you would grow radish little baby sprouts just like you would grow these guys. They're by far the easiest and the fastest growing. Then I think I'd probably encourage you guys to do the sunflower greens because they're actually going to provide a lot of bulk and actually a lot more weight, physical weight of the product because the leaves are so dense and the stems are so dense. Then maybe I'd go with the buckwheat. The buckwheat's a lot lighter weight product, but still delicious. Oh, and then of course the pea sprouts, really good. And then finally, you know, and go with the wheatgrass. You know, the wheatgrass, you can't just cut it and eat it, or cut it and put it in a salad, or cut it and put it in a soup, or cut it and put it into your vacuum blender to blend it up, or cut it and, or you know, eat it easily. The wheatgrass should optimally be juiced, and you would need a special juicer to do the wheatgrass unless you wanted to use your teeth, which are our best juicers given to us for free, so you don't have to buy anything. But the problem is chewing all the wheatgrass and chewing it into a dry mush and then spitting out the pulp and swallowing all the juice. But yeah, so once they harvest this fresh, then it actually goes into their cooler for a couple hours just to chill it out, because you know the sprouts they ship go across the country. They could be going as close as Orlando, or it could be going up to New York City, or even California. So once they harvest all the sprouts, then they actually go into the cooler to kind of pre-chill them just for a little bit. And this cooler is probably around in the between 30 and 40 degrees. And if you could look inside there, it's nice and cool. So they put all the sprouts to cool down so that on the shipment, you know, they stay fresh for you guys. And then the guys actually pack it and ship it, pack it in the boxes, and then actually they put them back into the cooler until the UPS guy comes to pick them up. And they only ship through air shipping because these guys would not make it through, you know, a couple days of just being in a box with the styrofoam insulation. So as you guys can see behind me, they got the guys just like packing the fresh cut sprouts in the packages using like the reflective kind of like a material that's going to keep the cold in. They also got the little freezer packs that you get to keep the sprouts cool. And while, you know, shipping sprouts all over the country is great and their business has expanded massively by doing this, actually, in my opinion, it's the best to grow your own sprouts, right? As much as buying fresh sprouts and eating them from grown in really excellent conditions and growing some of the highest quality stuff, it is even better to grow your own. So I want you guys to take the time to grow your own, because once you get set up, once you start to learn how to do it, it's really simple. And then you could save lots of money and actually even have a fresher quality product than one that's been cut, cooled and chilled properly and then sent to you. So that's what I want to share with you guys next. Actually, we're going to go into the Got Sprout store and show you guys all the different supplies you guys could buy. And actually, we're going to sit with the owner, Sean, and he's going to show you guys how to grow your own sprouts at home. So just walking out of the warehouse grow area, I'm on the way to the store, and I see this big container here, right? It's like a big garbage, bin. And what they're doing here is actually all the soil and the roots that are basically cut, they then take this and actually they put in this container, and this container is then sent to a farm to get composted, and then the soil could come back and the soil is reused to grow other crops in. So, you know, this basically closes the loop, and this is something that's very important. If you do get fresh sprouts here, they will be reusing the soil for you guys, so you guys don't have to worry about it. But if you buy fresh sprouts, you know, from here and you have the soil, I would encourage you guys to take the soil out and the roots and actually compost it in your yard. I mean, the easiest thing to do is just put it on the ground and cover it up with some leaves and just keep piling leaves and this stuff, or wood chips and this stuff, and it'll all break down over time for you guys. And if you guys are growing your own sprouts and you always have these extra leftover trays, right, don't throw them away. I've even been to some of my friends' houses that still are throwing this stuff away because they can't easily dispose of it and they're creating a lot of it. I want you guys to create systems and compost systems so you guys could probably reuse your soil and your roots, because there's nutrients in the soil and in the roots, and the little cuttings that you didn't eat, the microbes will eat them and actually turn it into a nice, rich, deep compost that'd be perfect for growing a vegetable garden, putting under fruit trees, putting under ornamental trees, or even just, you know, spreading out underneath the bushes in your yard. So yeah, if I remember, I'll put a link down below to a video I did on composting so you guys could learn how to properly compost the seed mats that you get once you grow your sprouts. So now I'm gonna take you guys into the Got Sprouts retail store. And if you come here, this is where you're gonna come. And they're actually open, I think, Monday through Thursday, like 9 to 6, Friday 9 to 5, and then Saturday like maybe 9 to 2. But check their website or call. I'll put their links down below so you guys can make sure they're open before you come. They're definitely closed on Sundays. Anyway, let's head inside and show you guys what they got growing on inside the store.
All right, let's head inside the store and see what they got here. Wow, this is a really nice store, a lot more fancy than their previous one. And as you guys can see, they got all kinds of paraphernalia. You know, they got little juicers and jars and sprouting lids and strainer bags, dehydrators, a nice little book section over there. Moving around, they got a tower garden right there. They got like really nice display of all these different books and things so you could grow your own sprouts and other health products like the Stockton Aloe 1. I like a lot. I actually probably drank a half bottle today. Little books, DVDs, and then behind the counter there, they actually will make your wheatgrass shots for you. They have kombucha on tap. That's really cool. And check it out. They have a whole container or a refrigerator of fresh sprouts, which are the most nutritious food on the entire planet. And that's why I'm here making this video for you guys. You know, I could have visited other farms today, but I'm here making a video on the sprouts because I want you guys to grow the sprouts honestly, seriously. It's the most important thing you could grow for your health and also the easiest as well. And you know, if you don't want to do it, you could come here to God Sprouts, pick them up fresh. They'll deliver in the local area, or they'll even ship them, the sprouts, to you. Over in this area, they got some natural care products. And also they got, this device called the Easy Sprout, which we'll be showing you guys. They got sprout lids, also ceramic knives, which actually I use in my own kitchen. But more importantly over here, they got all the different seeds that you will need to grow your own sprouts. So actually, let's sit down and talk about it. So now we're here at the seed store here at God Sprouts. And the cool thing about God Sprouts, unlike other places that will sell you guys sprouting seeds, is that these seeds are the same seeds they're using to grow the sprouts that I just showed you guys. So these are high quality seeds. You know, many different sprouting seed sellers, and you know, you could get sprouting seeds on Amazon, but you gotta kinda wonder, like, are those really good for sprouting? Did somebody just say we're selling these as sprouting seeds and they just bought cheap seed and they just put the word sprouting in front of them and they charge double the amount they could get for them, right? So it's really important, and I wanna encourage you guys to buy from a reputable source if you guys have the money for it, you know? And if it's like so much cheaper, and John, I could do it if I buy them on Amazon from some unknown guy that might not have real sprouting seeds, I might not get good germination. I might get extra mold growth in there, you know? They might be contaminated because they're not bacterial tested. Go ahead and do that, right? But you know, I like to say, do the right thing the first time, and these seeds, you could totally trust that they will work for you, and at least you're gonna take the problem of having bad seeds just out of the equation, right? There's a lot of things that could screw up with sprouting, and I don't want you guys to have bad seeds, so that's why like a place like God Sprouts or other reputable seed seller would be very good to go through. And you know, here actually I was looking at the prices actually for their certified organic seeds here, and I was pretty amazed, like they're pretty affordable, right? So like, the one I would grow the most, and I recommend it to you guys, is the radish. The radish is only $7.36 per pound. That's pretty inexpensive, you know. I don't want you guys to buy like 25 pounds at once because you're gonna grow a lot of radishes. You know, I'd only want you guys to grow, buy like a pound or two or three at a time, and don't keep a major inventory because as the seeds get older, you know, the germination rate may go down. So don't buy seeds now for 5 years unless you're one of those prepper types. And of course, yeah, buy the seeds and store them properly, and they could last for many years, but germination rates will go down. And of course, you know, some of the other things that I think are really good to grow, of course, the broccoli. So the broccoli seeds are quite expensive. They're $25 a pound, but it's actually probably the most expensive seed they sell. So don't get dissuaded. Grow the radish, and the radish has very similar nutrients to the broccoli, and also they grow a little bit easier based on my experience. After that, you know, something like the sunflower greens, let's see over here. And these prices are subject to change. You know, at this time, this is what they are, and you may be seeing this video a couple years after I've filmed it. So, you know, prices fluctuate, prices go up, shipping and transportation get more expensive. Sunflower seeds are only $5.85 a pound. So that's really inexpensive. You could grow lots of sprouts with this amount of seeds. And I mean, if you're still buying sprouts, whether it's from God Sprouts or whether it's from your local health food store, I mean, a pound of sunflower greens, you know, in the store, sometimes they're like 10 bucks a pound or more, depending on where you live. So if you buy a pound of seeds, that'll literally, you could grow several pounds easily of the sprouts just from an investment of the seeds, right? And so, yeah, that's some of my favorite ones. I mean, the buckwheat groats, you get the whole buckwheat, it's $4 a pound. And of course, what we'll be talking about next are some of the bean sprouts. They're the easiest ones to grow. The lentil sprouts are some of my favorite, the green lentil. They're around $5 a pound. Adzuki, Oh, and don't forget, you could grow your own arugula microgreens. They're $18 a pound. So anyways, and they of course also sell the different plastic trays you guys will need to grow your sprouts as well. I mean, basically they got everything you need. So I mean, I'll put a link down below to their website, gotsprouts.com. They got a full website explaining all the different products they offer. Anyways, next I think I wanna get the owner, actually he's set time out of his busy day for me, so I'm really grateful. Sean, who's been in my videos before, I'll post a link down below to the original video I did at Got Sprouts. And we're just gonna simply show you guys how to sprout some beans that can be done in just a few short days, so you guys can increase the quality of the food you're eating by eating the sprouts that are full of life enzymes. So now I'm here with Sean Herbert, the owner and master grower and owner, and he wears many hats here, at Got Sprouts. And what he's gonna do today, and we're gonna explain to you guys how easy it is to grow your own sprouts. And today I figured I wanted to show you guys something really easy, because I know a lot of you guys might be scared. John, I've never grown food before, I don't know what to do. Well, let me tell you guys, sprouting is absolutely the easiest food you guys can grow, because you're literally done in just a few short days, and you're eating and reaping the rewards of you being a gardener. And so this could really help you gain confidence for growing outside the next season. Plus, it's just something you can do indoors year round, no matter what the weather's like. So today we're gonna just do this, guy. This is the organic bean mix. So Sean, you wanna take away and explain to my people how to use some of the different items you have, whether it's the easy sprout here, the sprouting lids, or even just like a sprout bag.
Thanks, John. This is one of the most exciting times for me, because when I teach people how to sprout, the very first thing I'll teach them is actually how to do the bean mix. And the reason being is because in 36 to 48 hours, you've got food ready to eat.
Wow, so just a couple days.
Yeah, some really neat things you can do. So when I got started sprouting back in the 70s, this is what I used, was the old time mason jar. And what I figured out was, you need a largemouth mason jar so you can stick your hand in and be able to get the sprouts out, one of the reasons. But what I also figured out was, instead of sprouting like one seed at a time in small little mason jars and things like that, what I like to do is I do them all together. So if I find a certain batch of sprouts that have the same soaking times and the same rinsing times, I'll actually do them all together. So to give an example, if you're using a mason jar, you can use the brassicas, which is the alfalfa, the broccoli, clover, and radish. Actually put 1 teaspoon of it, because those are 1 to 5, and actually will fill this entire jar full of sprouts by the time you're
filled. Oh, together, so you grow them all together. Yeah. That's actually, I encourage you guys not to just grow a single variety, but grow all different kinds. Yeah. Actually, do you sell like a brassica mix for people?
We actually do, yeah. So
I would recommend that, yeah.
And the neat thing is, because they're 1 to 5, you only need a little bit at a time. So
1 teaspoon
of each will fill up this entire jar within about 5 to 7 days.
And so what's the weight of the seeds going in versus the weight of the produce coming out?
It's about 1/4 cup, and so 1/4 cup times 5, whatever that is. So it's going to be 1.5 cups, I guess, of sprouts. So it'll actually fill up this entire jar full of sprouts for you. And then you can pull them out and you can use them for on top of salads and soups and sandwiches, anything you want to add a crunch to. But one of my favorite ones I like to teach people about is actually the bean mix. And the reason why I like the bean mix is because you're going to have all these different types of flavors all done the same way. You can have the same soaking times, same rinsing times. And these are done within about 36 hours. So you're going to have food very, very quickly. So I'll show you kind of a neat way I do those. Also, if you're using the mason jars, I'd like to recommend to get these little jar toppers. And they have different size screens on them. So the yellow one will be for the brassicas, which are the smaller seeds. The larger one, the green one, was for fenugreek. And the largest one, which will be used for the bean mix, actually has a really big screen for it, so it'll drain the water out a lot quicker.
Yeah, so I want to say, you know, it's very important to get the right size screen. I mean, you could grow the beans with a smaller screen, but then there'll be like more leftover water, and then that's more of a probability, because it's going to be a little bit too moist, too wet for maybe not growing properly, and they could ferment and kind of get weird.
Yeah. So get the correct one for it. And the nice thing about these, they're reusable, so you can use them over and over again. You never have to buy another batch of them, so they work really well. So this is what, well, you put those over there for a second. One of my favorite things to use is what they call the easy sprouter, John. I know you've done some.
Yeah, I love that. It's probably one of the best manual sprouters on the entire market. Yeah.
The thing I love about it is when you get it, turn around the back, it gives you all the directions on how to grow it. Very simple. And when you open up, here's the parts to it. It has a great informational packet that comes with it. If you go to the last page, it actually has all the sprouting and all the soaking times for all your seeds. So it's a really good one. I tell people to cut that out, laminate it, and keep it next to your sprouting kit so they can use it whenever they want to. It's a very simple idea. What this guy came up with was brilliant. It's simply two pitchers, a solid pitcher that doesn't have holes and a pitcher that has holes in it. And you simply slide that in there like this. Now when we're doing the bean mix, John, you use, it's 1 to 3, so whatever one bean you put in, you'll get 3 times as much in sprouts.
Oh, wow.
So a pound of this will give you 3 pounds of sprouts, so you don't need that much. So with the easy sprouter, what I do is I'll take the cup that has the holes in it, and I'll simply pour a third of the cup in it. Fill it up about a third of the way. And this you do right before in the morning. As soon as you wake up in the morning, just go ahead and fill up a third of a cup, put it down like this, and then fill this up with water.
How much water do you just to cover them all?
Yeah, pretty much. I go to about 3/4 of the way with it, because
right.
The beans really do absorb a lot,
exactly.
So they'll actually go up quite a bit. If anybody has pets, they has a little measuring cup that comes with it. And this is my trick with pets. If you have pets, I get probably 3 or 4 pitchers from my customers with their dog or cat's head stuck in these things. So
really?
To protect your sprouts, put that in the top of it. That way the dog or cat can't get into the sprouts, because pets love sprouts. Wheatgrass, sunflower, they go after everything. So,
yeah, especially
so
cats.
They get into everything. So simply soak this overnight. So 24 hours you're going to soak it. When you lift this up the next morning, it simply drains out. Very simple. And what you're going to do is shake it around a little bit, get all the water out of it. Pour all the water out.
And you use that water on your garden outside, or put it in some trees or plants outside.
Right.
And use it. Don't just put it down your sink.
And I also recommend that you soak your rinse your seeds first before you soak them, because
right.
A lot of the farms will actually pack them with diatomaceous earth, so you get a lot of diatomaceous earth. So rinse them out really good before you actually soak them. So I'll work around it. Spin around like that, and then you can set it up like this. It's got a little ledge that it sits on, and that creates natural aeration, so it really gives some great airflow through them. So you don't run into as many mold issues and things like that with these ones. So I really do love that. So you're going to soak that, rinse it out the next morning. That afternoon, when you come home from work, rinse it out one more time. The next morning, they're going to have these tiny little tails on.
Mm-hmm.
And I always teach, like, the bean itself, once the tail is as long as the bean itself, that's the highest nutritional value.
Uh-huh.
What I like to do is, as soon as it gets a little tail in it, I'll drop this down like this, put a lid on them, and keep them in the refrigerator.
Mm-hmm.
They'll continue to grow in the refrigerator and keep up getting more nutritious over the days. After about 3 or 4 days, because the garbanzo gives off a lot of starch, you may want to rinse it out one more time, because it gets a little sticky there. And so you can simply use this, pull it out, use as much as you want. This entire jar will be filled with sprouts after 36 hours, so this is what it looks like here for you. So you got these little tails on them, and it really gives a lot of nutritional value for them. They're very high in protein, great for digestion, gets everything moving, and you do a lot of juicing. Have you ever juiced beans?
I haven't. Actually, that'd be interesting to juice those. I don't know what it tastes like.
I'm
kind of scared.
If you actually add this, it'll make your, like, a smoothie. It makes it creamy.
Oh, wow. That'd
be
cool.
I wouldn't think that, but it's really kind of a neat way to do it.
Well, here, I'm going
to
try some here for you guys on the camera. Put some out. And yeah, you could eat these guys fresh. And, you know, I like to eat them when the tails are real nice and small, because they're kind of more delicate in flavor and they don't get all kind of starchy and weird. But even if they're grown too long, you can still cook them up, steam them up, and still eat them, right?
Yep, or juice them.
You're juicing when they get too long, huh? So what are some things that people could do with the sprouts? Because once you got these guys, aside from making a sprout salad, which you could just have a bowl of this with some dressing on top, you know, whether you want to blend up some macadamia nuts and some orange juice, or whether you got a bottled dressing with all these preservatives, which I don't recommend, you know, mix it in, because any way you guys could get more sprouts in you would be definitely good.
Yeah. One of my favorite things to do is when I travel, take one of these little guys with it. You know, it's called a sprout bag or a nut milk bag. Get one with a string on it. They usually come in hemp or nylon. You can use them. It's really easy to use. But what I had this great opportunity a couple years ago. We got to travel to Spain, and we were actually juicing for a number of people. And the fun thing that we got to do is, I don't know if you guys have ever been over to Europe, but they have these tiny little salads in there. So we didn't know what we were going to eat while we were over there. So I smuggled a whole pound of bean mix with me. So I got to my hotel room. I pulled this out, put a whole pound of bean mix in here. I didn't have anything to soak it, so I got my ice bucket, stuck it in the ice bucket, and soaked it overnight. The next morning, I took it and put it over my sink in my bathroom on the light hanger from the light fixture. I went to the event, came back, rinsed it out one more time, put it up there. The next morning, I had 3 pounds of sprouts. This bag was actually overfilling with sprouts.
Oh, my gosh.
So my wife, this is the funny part. My wife works for Marriott Resort for about 15 years ago. And she has no fear of walking into a commercial kitchen and asking anything that she wants. So she walked in there, she goes, anybody here speaks English? And one guy raised his hand and goes, you're with me, let's go. Walked around the hotel room, and actually the hotel kitchen, and she got cumin, she got lemon, she got garlic, she got all different types of spices, salt, pepper, oil, and vinegar. She blended some of this up and actually made a hummus out of it. So a portion of it, she made a hummus of it, kept that in her
with all your bean, with all your sprouted bean mix.
So she made a hummus out of it, and then the next thing she did, she took about a handful of it, put oil, vinegar, salt, pepper, kept that in the refrigerator, and that was her snack food.
Wow.
And then she took onion and cayenne pepper and stuff, did some more different things. There's so many things you can do with a bean mix, so that's why I love the bean mix. And you can put it on salad, soup, sandwiches, anything you want to add a crunch to. Again, you can also juice it. It makes your juice creamy, like smoothie. So it's really some really cool things you can do with it.
You just got me hungry. I want some of that like hummus stuff you guys made. It sounds really good. But yeah, I mean, so why would somebody want to like sprout their beans first to make a hummus? Because I know normally there's just people to make hummus use like canned garbanzo beans or something. Like, what's the difference in using the fresh sprouts
to make your hummus? Have to sprout them. You just soak them for a certain period of time. You don't even need the tail on it to make the hummus. It's just basically soaking with the kind of.
But why is it better to use these guys instead of the canned beans to make a hummus?
Oh, absolutely, because it's live. You want live enzymes in your body, so you want the most life force you can get in your body. So if you soak them, it actually activates the seed. And they say that a dormant seed, once it sprouts, is 6 times more energy that's giving off. And think of sprouts like children. They're like little alkaline batteries bursting with the energy for growth, so they just explode with energy.
Wow.
So that's what you want.
So if you want to have more energy, start sprouting and eating these sprouts so you could get full of this life. So
absolutely.
Sean, I know you've heard many testimonials over the years you've been around in the business. What are some testimonials like that people have had just by simply including more of the sprouts in their lives?
Yeah, I've had so many great stories I could tell you. My own story, I was diagnosed with Crohn's disease back in 2004. And I used basically wheatgrass, sunflower sprouts, pea greens, and these bean mix and things like that to get myself off of medication and get life force back into your body. So it saved my life, and that's how I started Got Sprouts. My wife is a 20-year cancer survivor, and she taught me how to do this. So it's kind of been a family affair all the way through this. And I had a great experience about a month ago. I had one of my oldest customers, who's 87 years old now. She came in, she reached across the counter right over here, and she grabbed me by the arm. She said, "Sean, you helped save my life."
Wow.
And when I tell people that, you don't realize what an honor that is to do that. So what I tell people all the time is learn how to sprout. Just these simple little techniques are, you're going to have food within 24 to 36 hours ready to eat, ready to go. Share it with people.
Wow.
Share it with your friends and family, your neighbors, and it'd be amazing the difference that you're going to notice in your life.
Yeah, you know, just by the inch it's a cinch, by the yard it's hard, just by sprouting and doing small changes in your diet. You know, you don't have to be a vegan or a vegetarian or a raw foodist overnight, but just by eating some living stuff, you're going to start feeling better, and hopefully you're going to want to take the next step and the next step and the next step to start eating healthier. And you know, the thing is, when you make your own sprouts and you eat these, guess what? You're displacing other junk foods you'd probably be eating, right? And so eat more of the healthy stuff and displace as much of the junk as you guys can, and you'll start feeling different. I mean, Sean has many testimonials. I've been in this industry for a long time, and I've heard many testimonials of people healing from different diseases, you know, and cancer. Not to say that you're going to get better, but my experience has been, hey, when people get on some of this stuff, your body has the best opportunity to heal. And even more importantly than just to heal, if you're sick, to just not get sick in the first place. Yeah. You know, I know I have a lot of young people watching me, and you know, if you start eating healthy now, you won't have to worry about all these major diseases that people get when they get older.
Yeah, and you want to put life force in your body. That's what we're talking about. Live food. And I think of it common sense wise, if we can continue to put dead processed food in our body, our cells begin to die, and they call it premature aging, right? But if we put live, enzyme-rich, nutrient-rich, life force-rich food into our body, what are we going to do then? We'll call it a live instead of a diet.
Yeah, and I mean, that's why I took time out of my day-to-day to come to God Sprouts, because, I mean, above any other thing, I mean, I like ashwagandha, and I like cannabis, and I like all these crazy things that I grow in my garden. But I mean, honestly, I am sprout deficient because I'm traveling so much. I don't have the time to hang out at my sprouts. I mean, I've been home one day a total this month. And you know, I mean, I got my full garden in the backyard. That's great. But even me, I need to be sprouting more. That's why I'm sharing it with you guys, because you guys could do it. Because you guys, if you guys don't travel a lot like I do, you're home all the time to take care of these babies that could just be done in just 3 days. So Sean, I got to get going to actually the next farm, but are there any other comments or words of wisdom you'd like to share with my viewers today about sprouting and the microgreens and everything you do here at God Sprouts?
Yeah, I mean, it's truly been a blessing for us. I mean, we started 12 years ago, and we just moved to a new location. We're in a much larger location now to be able to serve our customers. And it's been amazing to watch it grow over these years. And the nice thing to do is you get to meet the people that come in. And they're more like family to us than anything, because they're coming and they're trying to learn how to sprout. They're buying sprouts from us. We're helping them all the way along the way. So it's truly been a blessing. And you know, this is a time for giving. This is, you know, Christmas and New Year's and everything. And it really is, I just want to say thank you for all my customers that are out there, and for John, for the videos that he promotes are unbelievable. And I've learned so much from you, so I've kind of enjoyed it over the years as well, too. So I just want to say thank you, and God bless, and keep sprouting, keep growing.
Yeah, cool. And the thing I want to say is that, you know, if you buy seeds and materials and all the things you need to grow the sprouts from God's Sprouts, they are here to support you, you know. They are a phone call away. You can call them wherever you live in the country. They'll pick up the phone and you say, hey, I'm having some challenges growing these sprouts or this. They'll walk you through and help you grow your sprouts and be there to hold your hand, even though they're not there to hold your hand. They're just a phone call away to help you guys. So, you know, you're not going to get that with some Amazon seller that you might save a couple bucks from, but you will get that from God's Sprouts, from an established business that's been growing now for 12 years and keeps expanding and growing. So, yeah, I want to thank you, Sean, for your work, because, you know, you probably have a harder job than I do. And all that stuff, but at the same time, I can see how it's so rewarding, because we both have similar businesses. We're helping people get healthier by just simply changing their diet and eating healthy foods.
Yeah, it's been a blessing. You know, we're both blessed by that.
Yeah,
and
awesome.
And our health as well. So.
Exactly. Yeah, and staying younger for longer, and being able to have the energy to do all the things we want to do.
Yeah.
Awesome. So, Sean, if somebody wants to purchase from Godsprouts, your phone number, your contact information, and how do they get a hold of you and buy your amazing seeds?
Yeah, you can go to Godsprouts.com, and simply Godsprouts.com, or give us a call at 561-689-9464. And we have a number of YouTube videos that are out there as well, too, to help you sprout. And, of course, we're always here to answer any questions you have. So.
Awesome. Great. So will you provide any special discounts for my Growing Your Greens viewers today?
If you order in the next couple of weeks, we'll give you 10% right off the top there. So just mention John Kohler, and we'll take care of it.
Yeah, so just give them a call to order. Right. Perfect. Awesome. Thank you, Sean. Yeah, so thanks for having me out and taking the time out of your day today. I really appreciate it. For you guys out there, if you guys like this video, like this episode, like learning about sprouts, and want to learn more about sprouts, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up. If I got a lot of thumbs ups, I'll try to come back next time I'm down in South Florida, make a trip out of my way to film more about sprouting. One of the best things, and you know, everybody should be sprouting, whether you have an outdoor garden or not. Also, be sure to click that subscribe button right down below so you don't miss out on any of my new upcoming episodes coming out about every 3 to 4 days. You never know where I'll show up or what you'll be learning to grow or even compost in my videos. Also, be sure to check my past episodes. My past episodes are a wealth of knowledge, over 1,300 episodes at this time. Teach you guys all aspects of how you guys can grow your own food. And be sure to check some of the links down below in the description. You know, like the previous episode I made with Sean here at Got Sprouts in their previous location to learn all about the sprouting. With that, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. And until then, remember, keep on growing.